This place here is called Kibuye 1 Parish. Around here we can contain around 4,000 people, and they are coming all over the country. The major health problems we are having a problem of the children who are suffering because of the dirty places we are having.
Hundreds of thousands of people live in slums like this in Kampala, without access to adequate housing, water, sanitation or health care. The conditions are particularly bad during the rainy season. Dwellings are often flooded and the stagnant pools of rainwater and sewage are ideal breeding grounds for malaria and other waterborne diseases. The local NGO ACTogether, working with the Slum Dwellers Federation, has been mobilising the settlement communities to map their own slums. ACTogether's Medi Lutwana explains why this has been so vital to addressing the issues of the slums.
The mapping aspect of our work is looking at first trying to understand the problem. Kampala has 63 slums, but the government does not have this information. They don't have the details. So to begin with, in terms of negotiation, you have to make sure that these slums are clearly mapped and they are understood and recognized. So the Federation and ACTogether has been doing this. We try to mobilize the people to collect the information themselves. And this information starts from the demographics, but also we go ahead to know how many structures, how many toilets, how many water points, how many wells, how many garbage centers within these areas. That information is used as a negotiation tool because communities use it to show who they are and also to identify their problems. We say that this data, first of all, organizes the community because the people will try to understand their settlements better. The people own the data and they use it and they value it to make sure they can, based on that, to engage and come up with constructive interventions. The idea is that after the community does its rough mapping, we also bring in other technologies with support from other organizations like UN Habitat, using the GPS machines and GIS softwares to make sure that we produce accurate maps. All the 63 slums of Kampala have been mapped and they have been put on the city map. We have already got a buy-in from the water company. They were designing a project to extend water and sanitation to the informal settlements. And that information has been critical in helping them to design the project because they could be able to identify the real slums and the actual families that could benefit from this project.
Armed with the knowledge gained from this profiling, forums have been created in the slums where the major issues affecting life in the community can be discussed. All the stakeholders are represented, including community leaders, NGOs and municipal officials. Historically, the municipality of Kampala has tended not to engage the community when providing services in the slums. Hassan Chiberu, chairman of the National Slum Dwellers Federation, says this has often led to failure.
When communities are not being involved, nothing can be sustainable. But involving the community, it lets the things of the development which has been done there be sustainable because people try to manage it, own it and try to understand that it's theirs. But when are not being involved, they will just say that's for the government. And in most cases, the city authority, they don't go to the settlements. They just sit in the office and just decide we are going to do this, we are going to make drainage. They just put the drainage where it is not necessary. They put the toilet where they don't need the toilet. All things just go like that.
Medi Lutwama says these forums have proved successful in starting to tackle some of the most pressing issues facing the slums.
The idea of the settlement forum is bringing that platform closer in the settlements to begin with. What are the basic issues that are affecting the community? And the community begins with a discussion, identifying the challenges, and we also push them to come up with alternatives to some of these challenges. What we have managed to achieve is that some of the issues that have been raised in some of the forums we have had The city authorities have started working on them. The communities have also started working on the issues that they should be working on as a community.
Kibuye One Forum member Amina Nakanike has seen how the forum has helped improve life in the slum.
Forum ene yambye nnyo abantu okumanya kiche baagala ne kiche bayinzo chikolera. Abantu abamba balowooza nti ekintu tekisoboka. Naye ate nga kisoboka katinga ekyakasasiro. Ngalowooza nti emmotoka tesobola kujja mmutuukako kutwala kasasiro oyo. Kyava amukwata n'amuyiwa mwala. Naye forum ene etuyambye nti tusobola okugenda ku state council ne tujjayo emmotoka ne tuzibaleetera ne basobola okubaggyako kasasiro. Naye ate luli kye baali tebamanyi nga forum tennaba kujja.
ACTogether has been keen to get universities to interact with the communities in the slums.
In 2012, we started a program which we call the Urban Studio. We realized that communities can collect data, but the universities can add value to this process by helping communities to analyze the data well and also to produce reports. So we started a partnership with Makerere University. Here in Kampala, we have piloted settlement planning using the data that was collected. And the communities have also started going to the university to teach the students how do communities collect information. And the students also get a chance to go to the slums to see what is the actual situation. We realize that in our teaching practice, there's been a very big gap between what the students are taught and what is actually on the ground, especially the urban planning department. Communities, the students were not getting time to go to interface with the slum communities. So the Urban Studio program has been helping us to share information with the academia, and also the academia adding value to the processes that the communities are doing. And it's working well. Our vision is to have the students and even the other professionals to start working out, developing visions for these settlements. Communities coming up with a dream that in the next 20 years, this is how we want our settlement to be. We don't have a road now, but in 5 years we would like a road, and this is where we would like this road to pass. This is where we would like a health center. This is where we would like a public toilet. And all the other social amenities, even in areas of housing, because housing has been left entirely to the slum dwellers. No plans are approved. So we want to start to change that mindset that even a slum dweller can contribute to the planning.